In this video, we're going to have a look at all the rivers that exist in the northeastern states of India. The northeastern part of India comprises of 8 states, and they are Sikkim, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura, and Meghalaya. Before we begin, I want to give you a rough picture of the geographic terrain that exists in the entire northeastern region of our country. I'll just quickly tell you in a very informal way. If you look at this map, as you can see, we have the state of Sikkim, then Bhutan as a country, and then the state of Arunachal Pradesh. Now, if you look at the India-China border, which is this line, this border line is nothing but the natural Himalayan mountain range. Even in the states of Nagaland, Assam, Meghalaya, Manipur, Mizoram, Tripura, you'll find traces of the Himalayan mountains. Here it is known as Purvanchal Mountains. Basically, it is the eastern extension of the Himalayan range. We also know that the Himalayan range is divided into different ranges. The first one is Trans-Himalayas, which is basically the main Himalayan mountains that lies in the Tibet and hence also called Tibetan Himalaya. The second one is the Greater Himalaya or Himadri. Here you will find the Mount Everest, Kanchenjunga ranges, basically the extreme northern part of Nepal, Sikkim, Bhutan and Arunachal Pradesh. Throughout the year it's covered with snow. You'll also find needle-leaved coniferous trees. There is not much of lush greenery. The third one is the Middle Himalaya. Now here most of the valleys and hill stations are located, basically the middle portion of Nepal, Sikkim, Bhutan and Arunachal Pradesh. You will find broad-leaved evergreen trees. That means lush green dense forest cover actually starts from this region. And the fourth one is Outer Himalaya, or we can say the foothills of Himalaya or the Shivalik Range. This is the southern region of Nepal, Sikkim, Bhutan and Arunachal Pradesh. Here the mountains are not very high. They are somewhere around 900 to 1200 meters. And below the Shivalik Range, you see this white portion of land, most of the Assam lies here. Then Bangladesh also comes. This is basically the plain, low-lying valleys, which are formed due to continuous running of Himalayan streams and rivers. In a rough, sketchy way, this place looks something like this. This is the outer boundary, then we have the inner boundary. Let's put some more inner boundaries. At the center, we have the Brahmaputra plain. If you look at this entire region from side angle, the landform looks something like this. The Tibetan region is higher in elevation, and from there the elevation of the landform gradually decreases. And the reason behind that is, around 10 to 50 million years ago, the Indian continental plate collided with the Eurasian plate, which led to the formation of the Tibetan plateau as well as the Himalayan mountains. Therefore, it makes absolutely sense to imagine the rivers flowing downwards with massive speed, and these rivers also carry huge amount of sediments, which by the way forms the plain low-lying area which we were talking about. So I hope with this informal illustration you're now able to imagine the geographic terrain that exists in the northeastern region of our country. Now that you have a rough picture about the terrain, it will be easier to study the flow of rivers in this region. Alright, let's go to the first state, Sikkim. One of the main rivers that almost flow right across the length of Sikkim is the river Tista. It originates in the Himalayan region of northern Sikkim. Then it flows to the south, where it flows along the Sikkim-West Bengal border, and finally enters into the state of West Bengal. From there, it turns southeast and enters into Bangladesh, and finally joins the river Brahmaputra and drains into the Bay of Bengal. The second river of Sikkim is River Rangit. Now this river originates in the lower Himalayan mountains of West Sikkim. While flowing southeast, the river forms the boundary between Sikkim and West Bengal. There's a point on the Sikkim and West Bengal border where River Rangit merges with the River Tista. The name of this place is called Tribeni. It's a touristy place where you can see River Rangit meeting Tista. And that's how River Rangit becomes a tributary of River Tista. And as we know, River Tista flows into the state of West Bengal, and from there it turns southeast and enters into Bangladesh. and finally joins the river Brahmaputra and drains into the Bay of Bengal. Another tributary of Teesta River is the river Rangpo. Now this river originates in the east of Sikkim and flows mainly from east to west, where it also forms the border between Sikkim and West Bengal. Again, even this river merges with the Teesta River. So these are the three main rivers of Sikkim. The only thing you have to remember is, first remember the river Teesta. That's the main river. It flows right from north to south of Sikkim, and then it enters the state of West Bengal. River Rangit originates in West Sikkim, flows towards eastern side along the border of Sikkim and West Bengal, and finally merges with River Teesta at Tribeni. And on the other hand, River Rangpo originates in East Sikkim, flows towards west along the border of Sikkim and West Bengal, and merges with River Teesta. Let's go to the second state, Assam. Now here the most important river is the Brahmaputra. Now Brahmaputra originates in the Angsi Glacier, located on the northern side of the Himalayas in Tibet. In Tibet, the name of Brahmaputra is River Yarlung Sangpo. Brahmaputra flows eastwards, parallel to the Himalayas. On reaching the Namcha Barwa, it is a mountain in the Tibetan Himalaya, it takes a U-turn and turns south to enter India from Arunachal Pradesh. Now I want you to understand this. The Tibetan Plateau is higher in elevation because the Tibetan Plateau was formed by continental collision between the Indian and Eurasian plate some 10 to 50 million years ago. This is also the reason behind the formation of Himalayan mountains. The Tibetan Plateau is also considered to be the highest and largest plateau in the world. So now I want you to imagine from a height of almost 4.5 km above the sea level, the Brahmaputra River enters into the state of Arunachal Pradesh. So imagine the speed of the river. With that much of speed, the river brings huge quantities of fertile alluvial soil. After entering Arunachal Pradesh, the river Brahmaputra suddenly turns into a braided river system, where the mighty river turns into a network of small channels. The river again turns to the southwest and enters into the state of Assam, which is a low-lying valley. The river flows through the Assam valley and finally enters into Bangladesh near Dhubri. Bangladesh is also a low-lying plain area, and that's how the river flows from Arunachal Pradesh to Assam and then finally into Bangladesh. From there, it flows to the south and finally drains into the Bay of Bengal. As you have seen, the river Brahmaputra travels through the entire breadth of the state of Assam. Now, along the way, there are several Himalayan streams that joins the river Brahmaputra. The first river is Subansiri. Although it originates in the Tibetan region of Himalayas, it flows east and southeast into Arunachal Pradesh, then south to the Assam Valley, where it finally joins the Brahmaputra River in Lakhimpur district. The second river is Kameng. Even this river originates from the Himalayas of the India-Tibet border. From there, it flows south and enters into the state of Arunachal Pradesh. It then enters into the state of Assam through Sonitpur district, and finally it joins the river Brahmaputra at Tezpur. The third river is Beki. It originates from the Himalayan glaciers in northern Bhutan. From there, it flows south in the Indian state of Assam and joins the Brahmaputra river basin. The fourth river is Manas. Now this river originates in the Himalayan mountains of southern Bhutan. In the state of Assam, it flows straight to the south and follows a meandering course for about 75 kilometers before joining the river Brahmaputra. And the fifth river is Gadadhar. It also has another name, which is Sankosh River. Now this river originates in the northern Bhutan and flows in the southern direction along the border of West Bengal and Assam, and finally drains into the Brahmaputra in the state of Assam. And the next river is Dihing. Now this river originates in the eastern Himalayas of Arunachal Pradesh and flows to the western direction, entering the state of Assam and joins the river Brahmaputra near Dihing Mukh. This river also creates many oxbow lakes in the area. An oxbow lake is a U-shaped lake that forms when a wide meander from the main stem of a river is cut off. So all these six rivers are tributaries of the river Brahmaputra, and they all originate from the Himalayan mountains and flow towards the low-lying valley of Assam. That's where all these rivers confluence with the Brahmaputra, and then Brahmaputra further flows in Bangladesh, which is again a low-lying valley, and finally drains into the Bay of Bengal. Now we will look at the rivers of Arunachal Pradesh. So moments back I told you that the northeastern states are a low-lying valley. Therefore it makes sense for the Himalayan glaciers to melt and flow as a streams of rivers in low-lying valleys of Arunachal Pradesh, Assam and Bangladesh. That's how many rivers flow and join the mighty river Brahmaputra and finally drains into the Bay of Bengal. Now some of the rivers are going to repeat again because Arunachal Pradesh borders the state of Assam and many of the rivers that flow in Assam has their upper catchment areas in Arunachal Pradesh. So the first river is Subansiri. Although it originates in the Tibetan region of Himalayas, it flows east and southeast into Arunachal Pradesh. Then it goes to the south in the Assam Valley where it finally joins the Brahmaputra River. The second river is Kameng. Now this river originates from the Himalayas of the India-Tibet border, or more specifically near southern Tibet. From there it flows south through West Kameng district of Arunachal Pradesh. It flows along the northern and western boundary of the Peke Tiger Reserve. It then enters into the state of Assam through Sonitpur district and finally joins the river Brahmaputra. The third river is Brahmaputra itself. We have already learned that Brahmaputra originates in the Angsi Glacier located on the northern side of the Himalayas in Tibet. In Tibet, the name of Brahmaputra is the river Yalung Sangpo. Brahmaputra flows eastwards parallel to the Himalayas. On reaching the Namcha Barwa, it is a mountain in the Tibetan Himalaya, it takes a U-turn and turns south to enter India from Arunachal Pradesh. Then the river goes further in the low-lying valley of Assam and then Bangladesh and finally drains into the Bay of Bengal. The fourth river is Dibang. It originates near the India-China border in the Dibang Valley district of Arunachal Pradesh. The river covers the districts of Dibang Valley and flows south through the Mishmi Hills and then enters the plains at Bomjir and Dambuk. Between Bomjir and Sadia, River Dibang has a steep gradient, meaning there is a drop in elevation. I've told you before also that the northeastern states are a low-lying valley, which becomes a natural slope for rivers and streams. So you can imagine the speed of the river when it passes through a natural slope. And then it forms braided channel, which basically happens when a river changes its course, and that results in flooding and destruction of cultivable lands and forests along its route. So between Bomjir and Sadia, the Arunachal and Assam border starts. That means the river Dibang then enters the state of Assam. And that's where it becomes a tributary of Brahmaputra. The fifth river is Lohit. This river originates in the eastern region of Tibet, where it is known as the Zayu River. It comes flowing down from the mountainous regions and enters into Arunachal Pradesh near Kaho village on the India-China border. From there, the river flows through steep hills and head towards the southwestern side and finally reaches the plains of Parsuram Kund. Parsuram Kund is a Hindu pilgrimage site located on low-lying plain area, which is also called the Brahmaputra Plain. Because here the largest river is the river Brahmaputra and it brings a lot of sediment, which has pretty much filled up this entire region, making it a plain area. And that's how the river Lohit enters into the Brahmaputra plain after reaching Parsuram Kund. And thereafter it enters the plain of Assam and finally merges with the river Brahmaputra. Alright, we are done with three states. Let's go to the state of Nagaland. The capital of Nagaland is Kohima. So the first river in Nagaland is Dhansiri. Now this river originates from Lysang Peak near the Koro village. This river is actually an extension of the Doyang River and it flows along the Assam-Nagaland border from south to north and forms a boundary between Karbi Anglong Plateau of Assam on the west and Nagaland. Finally, it merges with the river Brahmaputra That means the southern region of the Assam-Nagaland border is higher in elevation. Or in other words, it has hilly terrain. Try to recollect the rough illustration that I gave in the beginning. The Brahmaputra plain is a low-lying valley in Assam. And almost every river from every northeastern state flows towards the Brahmaputra valley and merges with the mighty river. So always remember, the Himalayan mountain in the east extends in this manner. That means the land elevation gradually decreases like this. And that's how water from Himalayan streams flow towards the Brahmaputra plain and merges with the big river. The second river is Doyang. It is one of the largest and most prominent rivers in Nagaland. This river originates in the Vokha district of Nagaland. Then it flows north where there is a dam and the river is part of the Doyang hydroelectric plant. From there, it makes a bend towards the southwest direction and proceeds towards the hills near Koro village and then finally falls in the Dhansiri river near Assam-Nagaland border. The third river is Dikhu river. Even this river flows from south to north and drains into the Brahmaputra river in Assam. Dikhu river flows across the Mokokchung and Longleng districts and forms a boundary between the both. This area is a hilly region, but the elevation gradually decreases towards the northern Nagaland-Assam border. The river then enters into Assam and flows right across the Shivsagar district and drains into the Brahmaputra near Dikhumukh. The fourth river is Milak river. It originates and flows in the Mokokchung district of Nagaland. It then flows towards the northern Nagaland-Assam border and enters Assam through the town of Tuli. Again, the reason is that this part is a hilly region and the land elevation gradually decreases towards the northern Nagaland-Assam border. And that's how the Milak river goes on to drain into the Brahmaputra river. And the fifth river is Chate river. It originates from areas near Medzifema and Chumukdima of Dimapur district. From there, it forms a boundary between Nagaland and Assam and finally merges with the Dhansiri river, which further enters the state of Assam and drains into the Brahmaputra river. The next state is Manipur. The capital of Manipur is Imphal. The first river of Manipur is River Barak. It originates from the Japvo and Lykoth hills of the Senapati district of Manipur. From there, it flows towards northwest direction and reaches the Manipur-Nagaland border. From there, it takes a bend to the southwestern side and flows along the Manipur-Nagaland border until it reaches the southern tip of the Manipur-Nagaland border near Konfung village. From there, the river flows further south inside the state of Manipur until it reaches a place called Tipaimukh at the Manipur-Mizoram border. The river then takes a sharp U-turn and flows northward along the Mizoram-Manipur border until it reaches the tri-junction border of Manipur, Mizoram and Assam. From there, the river continues to flow along the Manipur-Assam border till it reaches Jirimukh. And then finally, the river enters completely in the state of Assam and changes its course towards west, passing through Lakhipur and Silchar and enters into Bangladesh. In Bangladesh, it is known by the name of River Surma and the Kushiyara and later called the River Meghna before receiving the combined flow of the Ganga and the Brahmaputra. The second river is Imphal River. It is a major river in Manipur that flows through the capital city of Imphal. It originates from north of Karong in the Senapati district. You'll notice the Senapati district is a hilly region, and as you go towards the capital city of Imphal, the land elevation goes down because Imphal is a plain area. So the river passes through the city of Imphal towards the south of Manipur. And then it finally reaches the Nongmaikhong village, which is located in the Thubal district of South Manipur. From there, the Imphal river joins the Manipur river, which goes further south and flows in Myanmar, Burma. The Manipur river merges with the Maitha river, a tributary of the Chinwin river in Myanmar. And Chinwin finally drains into the Bay of Bengal. So we can say it thereby connects Imphal city to the sea. And by the way, during World War II, the Japanese soldiers used the Imphal river to reach the city of Imphal. The third river is Iril. It originates from the Ganju village located in the Senapati district of Manipur. The river flows south towards the capital city of Imphal. If you look at the landscape, the city of Imphal is located on a plain area. Therefore, it makes sense when we say the flow of river from hilly region of Senapati district to the plain area of Imphal. Iril River flows from the eastern side of Imphal and takes a turn towards the west of Imphal, where it finally joins the Imphal River near the Lilong Bridge in Thubal district of Manipur. Imphal River, as we know, flows to the south of Manipur, where it becomes the Manipur River, which further flows south and enters Myanmar, Burma. The fourth river is Manipur River. It starts from the Nongmaikhong village, which is located in the Thubal district of South Manipur. If you see, that's where the Imphal River ends. That means Manipur River is the southern extension of the Imphal River. Or in other words, the Imphal River is the tributary of Manipur River. Manipur River, which goes further south and flows in Myanmar, Burma. The Manipur River then merges with the Maitha River, a tributary of the Chindwin River in Myanmar. And the Chindwin River finally drains into the Bay of Bengal. The fifth river is Nambul River. It flows right through the heart of Imphal city. Now this river basically is an inland waterway that used to connect the villages of the southern and eastern part of the Manipur hills and valleys with the main commercial market in Imphal. Now it is heavily polluted and looks more of a sewage drain than a river. The sixth river is Tuiwai River. This river originates in the Churachandpur district in the southwestern corner of the Indian state of Manipur. The river forms part of the boundary between India and Myanmar and part of the boundary between the Indian states of Manipur and Mizoram. The major portion of the river flows along the southwestern side of Manipur-Mizoram border and finally drains at a place called Tipaimukh. If you can recollect, it is the same place where the Barak River takes a U-turn and enters in the state of Mizoram. That means the Tuiwai River is a tributary of the Barak River and it becomes so at a place called Tipaimukh. The next state is Mizoram. The capital of Mizoram is Aizawl. And the first river is the River Barak, about which we have already read. And I'm not going to repeat it again. I'll just show you the river route again. So throughout the entire journey of the River Barak, when the river reaches a place called Tipaimukh at the Manipur-Mizoram border, the river then takes a sharp U-turn and flows northward along the Mizoram-Manipur border until it reaches the tri-junction border of Manipur, Mizoram and Assam. So this much of journey of the River Barak that flows along the Mizoram-Manipur border makes it somewhat part of Mizoram. Now I really don't know whether this much of flow of a river can be called as a part of Mizoram. Anyhow, just keep in mind and there is nothing much about it. Alright, the second next river is Long. It is spelled as T-L-A-W-N-G, but you pronounce it as Long. T is silent. Now this river is one of the longest rivers in Mizoram. It originates at the Zopoy Hill near the Lungle town, situated in the south central part of Mizoram. From there it flows towards the northern part of Mizoram, passing through the capital city of Aizawl. By the way, the capital city of Aizawl is a plain area. Therefore, it is needless to say that this particular river flows from south to north because the land elevation is higher in the south and it gradually decreases towards northern direction. However, there are few rivers that flow in Myanmar. Otherwise, most of the river flows to the northern direction and goes into the Assam Valley, joining the Barak River system. Anyhow, even the Long River enters Assam and joins the Barak River, which flows in Bangladesh and drains into the Bay of Bengal. The third river is Teo. Again, even this river is a long river. It originates in the extreme eastern side of Mizoram, in the Champai district. Now, Champai is a border town in Mizoram state. This river flows along the eastern Mizoram-Myanmar border from north to south till Pankhua village of Longtle district of Mizoram. Therefore, this river naturally forms the land boundary between India and Myanmar in the state of Mizoram.
The fourth river is Kaladan. Now this river is also called Chimtuipui River. This river originates at the central region of the Chin state in Myanmar. So this entire region is the Chin state. And it is an extremely hilly region with the average height of hills being 2000 to 2500 meters above the sea level. The river flows to the south within the Chin state of Myanmar. And from there, it flows in the south direction and enters in Mizoram. Now, this river takes the north direction for about 120 to 130 kilometers, marking the international boundary between Mizoram and Myanmar, and meets the river Tio in the opposite direction. Now, Tio River flows along the Mizoram-Myanmar border from north to south till Pankhua village of Longtle district of Mizoram. Once it meets the Tio River, from this point, the flow direction is diverted towards northwest, where it meets the river Tuichang and eventually flows southward and again enters Myanmar from the southern border of Mizoram. Once the river is in Myanmar, from there it continues to flow southward and meets the Bay of Bengal. So in a nutshell, the Kaladan River originates in the central part of the Chin state in Myanmar. From there it enters Mizoram and flows towards northwest and then to the southern part of Mizoram, and that's where it again enters Myanmar and finally drains into the Bay of Bengal. The fifth river is Khotlang Tuipui. It is a long word, but there is another name to this river, which is Karnafuli. So we are going to use the name Karnafuli instead of Khotlang Tuipui. It originates from the Saita village of Mamit district in Mizoram. From there, it flows southwest towards Bangladesh. The place from where it enters Bangladesh is called Tegamuk. It then passes through the Chittagong Hills towards the port city of Chittagong and drains into the Bay of Bengal. The sixth river is Tuichang. This river originates near the Wankal village in the Champai district of Mizoram. It then flows towards the south upon reaching the town of Nathial in Lungle district. It merges with the Karnafuli River, which flows in Bangladesh to the city of Chittagong and drains into the Bay of Bengal. The seventh river is Tuirial. There is another name given to it. It is also called the Sonai River. It originates from Chaolung Hills, which is basically located south of Aizawl district. It flows in the state of Assam from the northern Mizoram-Assam border and finally joins the river Barak, which flows west into Bangladesh. The eighth river is Tut. It originates from the hills of Tenlum village in Lungle district of Mizoram. The river flows to the north and joins the Long River near a small village called Langkhang in the Mamit district. And as we know that River Long passes through the capital city of Aizawl and enters into the state of Assam and finally joins the Barak River. Broadly speaking, these are the major rivers of Mizoram, and there are few minor ones which don't really matter because they have a very short length and eventually confluence with the major rivers. The next state is Tripura. The capital city of Tripura is Agartala. The first river is Gomti. It originates from Dumbur Lake, which is located in the eastern hilly region of Tripura, and flows towards the western side and enters Bangladesh and joins the Meghna River branch in Bangladesh, which further drains into the Bay of Bengal. The second river is Manu. It originates from the mountains of Chamanu and flows to the north towards Tripura-Bangladesh border. The river enters Bangladesh near Kailashahar city and passes through the mountainous terrain and meanders around the Silhet Plain. So if you see, Silhet Plains is the northeastern division of Bangladesh. Manu River then joins the Kushiara River at Manumukh in the Bangladeshi district of Maulvi Bazar. The third river is Sumli. Now Sumli is a small river originating from the Damra Hills of Boromura Hill Range, which is right here. It's a centrally located hill range in Tripura, mainly in West Tripura and South Tripura districts. It flows northwest and enters into Bangladesh, where the name changes to Sonai River, and that further merges with the Titas River, which is, by the way, a tributary of Meghna River and drains into the Bay of Bengal. The fourth river is Khowai. It originates in the eastern part of Atharamura Hills of Tripura. It flows northwest, it leaves India at Khowai district and enters Bangladesh at Balla in Habiganj district. It flows further north, then it turns west and joins the Kushiyara River near the Bangladeshi district of Kishorganj. As we know, the Kushiyara River is a tributary of River Meghna, which finally drains into the Bay of Bengal. The fifth river is Juri. It rises at the Jampui Hills of the Indian state of Tripura, which is in the extreme eastern side of Tripura-Assam border. The river flows north. A good amount of it flows along the northern Tripura-Bangladesh border. The river enters Bangladesh through the Kulaura Upazila of Molvi Bazar district. Later, it joins the Kushiyara River at Fenchuganj Bazar. Further, we know that Kushiyara River is a tributary of River Meghna, which finally drains into the Bay of Bengal. The sixth river is Feni. It originates in the southern Tripura-Bangladesh border and flows through Sabrum town and then enters Bangladesh. That's how it is called as a transboundary river. I mean, any river that flows on the border of two countries, or in other words, the river itself becomes a boundary between two countries, is called a transboundary river. Anyways, the river flows southwest after entering Bangladesh and finally drains into the Bay of Bengal. So these were the main rivers in Tripura. As you know, most of it either joins the River Meghna directly or joins the River Kushiyara or Titas, which are the tributary of River Meghna. So either way, it tells us that the Tripura is a hilly region and the land elevation gradually decreases towards the deltaic basin of Bangladesh, and that's why all the river flows into Bangladesh. And the last state is Meghalaya. The capital of Meghalaya is Shillong. The first river is Digaru. It originates in the border of Garo Khasi Hills. Digaru River flows towards the northeastern direction and enters the state of Assam from Birnihat village in Ribhoi district of Meghalaya. The river continues to flow northeast and joins the river Kopili, which further merges with the Brahmaputra River. The second river is Kopili. Now this river is a long river. It originates from the Jhenshya Hills, which is in the extreme eastern part of Meghalaya. From there, the river flows along the eastern Meghalaya-Assam border and then enters the state of Assam. The river keeps flowing in the northern direction and takes a slight bend towards the northwest. And it flows through central Assam and the hill districts of Assam before it flows into the Brahmaputra. The third river is Mintdu River. Even this river originates in the Jhenshya Hills, which is the extreme eastern part of Meghalaya. This river encircles the town of Jowai and then flows to the south. Since this entire place is a hilly region, you will notice that the rivers form into a natural waterfall. Finally, the river enters into Bangladesh through the village of Kamsing, which is located at the extreme southern part of Jhenshya Hills. After entering Bangladesh, the name of the river changes to Shari Goyen River. The river continues to flow towards southwestern direction and passes through the Silhet Plain of Bangladesh and joins the Surma River, which further joins the Meghna River and drains into the Bay of Bengal. The fourth river is Someshwari. This river originates in South Garo Hills of Meghalaya. Actually, this river divides the Garo Hills into two parts, South Garo Hills and West Garo Hills. In Meghalaya, the name of the river is Simsang. It flows to the south and enters Bangladesh near the town of Baghmara in South Garo Hills. Once the river enters Bangladesh, the name changes to Someshwari River. It flows through the Susang, Durgapur and other areas of Netrakona district till it flows into the Kangsha River. The Kangsha River then flows into the Surma River, and the Surma River, as we know, joins the Meghna River and drains into the Bay of Bengal. So these were the rivers of Meghalaya, and with this, we have come to an end of this video. The purpose of this video was to show you all the rivers that exist in the northeastern states of India. And I hope this video met your expectations. So let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.